If you use Excel to generate and execute lists, then at some point you may want to learn how to get a check mark on your worksheet. In Excel, the check mark is treated as text, so it means that the color and size can be changed just like any other text would be, and the location can be changed using your regular copy and paste commands. There are lots of ways to insert a check mark in Excel. We'll look at 5 commonly used methods in this tutorial. Method 1 is to use Shift P in the Wingdings 2 font. Since a checkmark is just another text character, if you can remember that Shift P is that character, then you would just type an uppercase P in your desired cell and change the font to Wingdings 2 and enter. The checkmark shows up on your worksheet, and this works both with Windows and Mac devices. Here's another little tip. If you type Shift O in the Wingdings 2 font, then you get the X symbol. So that was method 1. Method 2 is to use the Insert Symbol menu option. So from the Insert tab, we go to the Symbol dropdown and click Symbol. In this dialog box, make sure we're at the Wingdings font option, not Wingdings 2. And scroll all the way to the end, and you'll see a check mark here. Click Insert, and we can see that a check mark is inserted here. You can also see that Excel stores your recently used symbols toward the bottom of this dialog box, which saves time if you need to insert them again. The third method is to use Alt-0252. So remember when we went to the Symbols dialog box and we used this symbol to insert our checkbox? This 252 character code is very close to the shortcut that we'll use in the third method. We just need to hold down the Alt key and then on our number keypad type 0252 and enter. When we get this symbol, we can just change the font to Wingdings and enter. And our check mark shows up. This Alt-0252 method isn't available on Mac devices. Method number 4 is the Unichar function. Yes, a check mark can be inserted using a function. Unichar is a text function which returns the character represented by the Unicode argument in parentheses. Remember that each character is assigned a special code within the computer's memory. Once you know the code for the character, then you can use Unichar to insert it. If you type equals Unichar, open parentheses, 10003, close parentheses, that inserts a check mark. If you type equals Unichar, open parentheses, 10004, close parentheses, that inserts a heavy check mark. This method offers the advantage of not having to change to a special font. Remember, though, that if you do choose to use the Unichar function, the check mark will be the only value in that cell because you're using a function. The final method we look at today is using conditional formatting. We may want to use conditional formatting to insert a check mark if a cell meets a certain condition. So here on this worksheet, let's say we have a target of 500 unit sales per month, and we want to see a check mark beside those months where this target was met, and maybe an X next to the months where it wasn't met. To apply conditional formatting, first we'll select the range where we'll want the check marks to appear. So that's right here, from B2 to B13. Then from the Home tab, we go to the Conditional Formatting dropdown, Icon Sets, and choose the indicators that have the check mark, the exclamation mark, and the X. What we see here is that these icons are placed following Excel's default rule. We'll want to go in and change that rule by going back to Conditional Formatting and Manage Rules. From the Rules Manager, we click Edit Rule, and here in the lower third of the window, we'll change the percent here to number. Because we're applying the conditional formatting based on the value, the number that's in column B. So we want to see a check mark when the value is greater than or equal to 500. We'll change the second symbol to an X and the type to a number. And we want to change this symbol to greater than. So if the value in the cell is less than 500 but greater than 0, then we want to see an X. We don't need a third icon, so let's select no cell icon here. We click OK. And if we click Apply, we can see that our changes were applied to our dataset, and we can click OK to confirm. So at a glance, it shows whether the monthly target was met or not. We could also see the symbols only if we wanted to. So if we go back to Conditional Formatting and Manage Rules, Edit Rule, and if we selected Show Icon Only and OK, when we click Apply, then the numbers are removed and only the icons show up. You can increase or decrease these icons by changing the font size. Once you've tried all five methods, you'll probably have a favorite or two. Check out our website to get more tips about using Excel.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.